This is not my maiden speech, so don't use the bell. Unlike Mr. Pandya sahab ki jaise ye meri pehli speech nahi hai, to isliye the time ki pabandi aap mat lagaiye sir. Sir, मैं सब सब मेरे साथियों से नेताओं का शुक्रगुजार हूँ इस सदन का. But I'm actually very overwhelmed by the things I've heard here, sir, from the leader of the house, from the leader of the opposition, from my very esteemed, respected colleagues. And एक चीज़ मैं ज़रूर कहूँ राम गोपाल जी, जहाँ पर भी मैं बैठूँ मैं दाएँ हाथ की तरफ देखूँगा आपके लिए. अब आप तो रहेंगे. And it was very touching. I mean, you'll of course evaluate my contributions, and it's not for me to talk about them. But I only want to, first of all, very sincerely express my gratitude for all the indulgence that you have shown, including you, the chair, sir, and for all the times that I have extended or stretched your patience and in terms of wanting to say something or share something. And thank you for everything that this house has given me. And it is actually, the last 12 years have been indeed one of the most important learning experiences as far as I am concerned. And I think this has also been a very crucial period in the political life of our country. And to that extent, I think the opportunity to play, to place a contribution into that circumstances is something that I am very grateful for. I entered this house very reluctantly, sir. First, it was told that in 1996, then we thought, and as many senior colleagues have mentioned about the thinking of my party and and our understanding, so we thought, we used to call this the gold building. So, kitni dur rahe gold building se utna acha hai, janta ke beech mein sangharsh karte rahe. Aur ye 1996 ki baat thi, fir baad mein 2004, gulam bhai nahi hai, wo khud व्यक्तिगत तौर पे बड़े नाराज़ थे मेरे से 2004 में, जब उन्होंने कहा कि नहीं, ये सीट आप ही के नाम पर हमने जो है अलग से रखा था, जब हम नहीं आ पाए. अब लेकिन 2005 में जब पार्टी के फैसले से कॉमरेड सोमनाथ जी को जब स्पीकर बनाया था, तब पार्टी ने कहा है एक आवाज़ चाहिए पार्लियामेंट के अंदर, तब आइए. तो उन संदर्भों में मैं पहुँचा यहाँ. और इससे पहले सर, I recollect an incident which I think I should say that. And well, that is in 2001. Remember, there was this very bad earthquake in Gujarat, and I had been sent by the party to do some relief work, and we built a colony there, and it's named after the Sherni of Bhavnagar, Neeruben Patel, that is still there. And on return, there was an all-party meeting convened by the then Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee. And Comrade Surjit, my party general secretary then, said that you go, since you've been there and you've done the work, so you go. So I entered the Parliament House with my pass, you know, through the gates, and walked up to the first floor, and very coincidentally, the Prime Minister emerged from the lift. So we were walking down, and while he was walking down, he said, "Kyun Yechury ji, aajkal aap house mein nazar nahi aa rahe." So I didn't know what house meant then, honestly. I said, I didn't know that these are referred to as houses, you know, houses of parliament. Then I thought, aap ghar pe aake nahi mil rahe unse, ye pata nahi kya tha, matlab I thought, to share respect, I walked off. That was the state, sir, before I entered this house. But having entered this house, I think it has been, as I told you, such a great experience that it has been here, that I've learned since the time I've come here. Bhairav Singh Shekhawat ji was the chairman. Rahman Khan sahab was the deputy chairman. Mr. Yogendra Narayan was the secretary general. Then I went through Mr. Vivek Agnihotri, a very dear friend of mine, in the sense that he and my uncle were batchmates in the IAS. And then, of course, Sharif, whom I had known even earlier as a very competent IAS officer. You, of course, sir, as the deputy chairman, who are still itching to ring the bell even today. when I speak, and to the entire staff here, sir, the ones who are standing there next to you, the ones whenever we wave a paper, they come. I mean, they just appear from nowhere, from invisibility. They just, you know, they just come here to actually do this. It's such a seamless operation. Our marshals, when we had to pass the Women's Reservation Bill, And the staff who sits here, sir, around this semicircle table, and whom we call the reporters, I would salute them, and I rate them as some of the best stenographers that the world has ever seen. And very rarely, only when I make a mistake in not quoting something correctly, and I write there, as I've written today for the speech I made yesterday, that it is not the reporter's mistake, it's my mistake in quoting that quote. And to all of them, sir, to everybody in the staff here, I would like to pay my gratitude. And all this has helped. But I notice only one thing, since you are the chair now at the moment, I can only tell you there's a lot of outsourcing and privatizing that is going on with the staff. I hope you don't end up outsourcing. They have allowed us to function and sometimes end up at 2 in the morning. They have served us food, they have protected us, they have removed people who are unruly, got us to do our business. This staff, sir, please take care of this. So from the officers who have served us here, sir. Devuda, Dr. Bandhupadhyay, I've known him from much before the time that has come, as also the first initial drafter of the land reform laws. Not only of Operation Burger, but the land reform under Binoy Chaudhary then. And we've known each other for a long time, of course. This is a lifelong dispute that I have with him, why he shifted from this end to the other end. and his complaint to me saying that, why are you sticking to your end? and that will go on. But he's been my senior and with great respect. I mean, that has always been there. And Pandya sahab, main khas yehi sochta tha ki aap pehle bhi ek aad baar bol lete house mein, to hame bhi thodi prerna mil jati, matlab Dilip bhai, matlab yaar prerna maane mauka mil jata khud thoda aur thokne ke liye RSS ko, to aapne hame wo opportunity deny kiya, matlab lekin saath hi chal rahe aap log bahar, lekin jo wapas aaye un sabko hamari badhai. Lekin sir, when I was talking about Debuda and the steel frame, or our Secretary General here, the ones before, who come from our IAS, IFS, and your police service, you know, what Sardar Patel called the steel frame that unites a country. This is the officers that unites a country. You have today, if the All India Institute, you refer to Amrita Kaurji. Rajkumari Amrita Kaurji. When he set up that AIIMS today, you go there today, every day the crowd of patients keeps increasing. Irrespective of the number of AIIMS we have opened up.
10,000 OPD.
Why? Because you have there the quality of the doctors who are not enamored by the crores they can make if they can go into a private hospital or go to Dubai, but they serve our country, sir. And we were talking of Satyendra Bose and you and Professor Bhargav, the scientist. And we are talking this morning of the chairman not using his honorary degree of D.L.I.T., never calling him a doctor. These are the value systems that this kept this country today. If you can fire a rocket to Mars, it is not because of any external technology that you got, but what we developed ourselves. And that is the faith I have, sir, as I leave this house, that we, this August house, will strengthen that internal strength of India.
Not on outsourcing.
And not through making ourselves dependent on others, but actually building our internal strength. That is, we look inwards to expand outwards.
Plagiarizing the culture.
And that, sir, can only happen. That can only happen, sir, if we actually understand the glory of what we are talking, what I am talking about. When Swami Vivekananda talks of the Vedantic mind in a Islamic body, that is the future of India. Swami Vivekananda was not somebody who didn't see what is the future of our country. It is only the syncretic evolution of India as we know today that is our strength. If on our diversity you try to impose a uniformity, whether it's a religious uniformity, whether it's a linguistic uniformity, whether it is a cultural uniformity, then this country can never remain together. It'll only implode. Our country can strengthen only when we strengthen the bonds of commonality that run through our diversity. And that bonds of commonality that run through our diversity, sir, that must be the focus. And I beseech this August House, because from my own experience of the last 12 years, it is not only that we reflect the concerns of the people outside, but we also give an agenda to the people outside that this is how the country... Talk about that, sir. When we say, Sara jahan se achha, Hindustan hamara. Hum bulbule hain iske, ye gulsita hamara. What is this, sir? We're talking of a garden where there'll be various flowers, there'll be various birds, there'll be various scents, and there'll be bees that'll be interconnecting between these flowers. That gulsita is our country. Let us not target any one specific group or anything else for our narrow, petty, immediate prospects. That in the long run will only undermine all of us together. So my only appeal there, sir, is that in today's situation, we are, I think, living in a period of what is normally called as the post-truth. Post-truth, sir, has been defined by the Oxford Dictionary as the most influential word of 2016, last year. And how does it define it, sir? It's called the word of the year 2016. It says that post-truth means, quote, relating to or denoting circumstances in which objective facts are less influential in shaping public opinion than appeals to emotion and personal belief, yes. Unquote. This post-truth is not Indian reality, sir. We have to get back to that Indian reality. When the Leader of the House, about whom I have very fond association for over how many, 45 years now? We go back to 45 years. He's not wrong when he says that we have grown up together. But he's also not wrong when I say that always through these 45 years, we're on the either side of the fence. You're there and I'm here. I mean, in terms of our ideological position. But yes, here, we will debate. We will debate. We will debate with all sides. We will debate, but then the point is, it is this country, this constitution that has to be strengthened and carried forward. And yes, to the Leader of the House, when he jokingly said that since Sitaram has never been in government and he makes all these atrocious demands and things that are not practical, I'm sure that's a value that they also share sometimes. I mean, you know, when they're in. Many a time.
It is adulterated.
No. But sir, one thing you must grant me, and my party. Though I don't believe in intellectual property rights, if there's any intellectual property right, sir, that we must be given without any hesitation, it is the concept of outside support. Outside support is the intellectual property right of the CPIM. That is something that you'll have to give.
Don't repeat that mistake.
No, that is. Of course, my friend Jairam, I mean, as he said, we go back to many years, but he didn't complete the whole story. He didn't complete the whole story. He said, Sitaram Yechury, I called you Sitaram Obituary. To which I always used to reply to him saying, this Jairam Mortuary. If his policies are followed, if his policies are followed, you'll be in the mortuary. But in the lighter way. But in the lighter way, I'd only say this, sir. But having.
One sec, Leader of the House. Jairam also has not changed. He continues to write obituaries.
Since we are speaking in this wonderful bonhomie and atmosphere, sir, but this post-truth, the battle against post-truth, sir, is something that really concerns me. It concerns us. We've spoken so often here. Please come back to the realities of what we are.
Yes.
Please understand the reality. Your farmers committing suicides, which are growing. Your youth that is going around the country feeling a sense of insecurity. We are the youngest country in the world. if we can give our youth education, health and jobs, nobody can stop India from being the leader of knowledge society in the world. We have that potential. Please address to those issues and let us not get diverted onto other unnecessary, issues of rupture, rather than unifying in order to build a better India so that we can create a better society in the future. Yes, that is the political approach. We have to take a political decision on how to do it. If there are those who believe in post-truth and rupturing the unity of this country, that needs to be fought. On that, there can be no compromise, and I shall never negotiate. That is not a negotiable issue. The unity of my country, the harmony of my society. And that is why, sir, I want to just finally tell you, please understand, when you talk of the syncretic culture, in this August house, I've not said this earlier, but I think I should say this, even to say that you tell me. There are millions of people like me in this country. I'm born in the Madras General Hospital, now called Chennai, the General Hospital in Madras, to a Telugu-speaking Brahmin family. My grandfather, being a judge, states reorganization, the Andhra bench of the High Court of Madras moves to Guntur, so we shipped there in 54. I'm born in 52, fifth to Hyderabad in 56. My school education is in an Islamic culture that was prevalent in Hyderabad under the Nizam rule in early days of independence of 56. Hamari taleem to wahi hui, sir. Wahi, ab usi taleem ke saath main aaunga. Then come to Delhi, study here. I'm married to a person whose father is a Sufi of the Islamic order, whose surname is the Chishti Sufis, whose mother is a Rajput, but a Mysorean Rajput who migrated there in the 8th century AD. We are now in the 21st century. She is the daughter of these two, father and mother, a South Indian Brahmin-born family, married to this lady. What will my son be known as, sir? What is he? Is he a Brahmin? Is he a Brahmin? Is he a Muslim? Is he a Hindu? Is he what? There is nothing that can describe my son rather than being an Indian. That is our country. That is my, I'm talking of my example. Just look at how many such people are there. It is that India, sir, that you are the custodian. We have all been the custodian. we are all the custodians of that India that we have to preserve. Isliye jaise main keh raha tha, mera taleem ki shuruaat hui hai Hyderabad mein. Aur taleem main samajhta hoon khatam nahi hoti, zindagi bhar chalti hai. Jab tak hum zinda hai, hum seekhte hi rehte hain. To Makhdoom Mohiuddin sahab the hamare Hyderabad ke mashhoor krantikari shayar. Aaj bhi CPI ka office ka naam Makhdoom Bhavan ke naam se jana jata hai. Ek communist the jinhone mashhoor us zamane mein gaane likhe the. ये जंग है जंगे आज़ादी आज़ादी के परचम के तले. और बाद में वो कहते हैं कम्युनिस्ट की विचारधारा, ये आज़ादी आज़ादी क्या मजदूर का जिसमें राज ना हो. अब उस राज के लिए हम भी लड़ते रहेंगे. लेकिन वही वो मखदूम का एक शेर याद आ रहा सर. मखदूम के बारे में आप सभी तो जानते हो, बाजार फिर आपने और उसके अंदर जो गाने और जो डायलॉग है वो सब छोड़िएगा. लेकिन आखिर में मैं यही कहना चाहता हूँ सर, हयात लेके चलो कायनात लेके चलो, हयात लेके चलो कायनात लेके चलो, चलो तो सारे ज़माने को साथ लेके चलो. यही मैं चाहूँगा कि मेरी गुजारिश यही है कि पूरे ज़माने को साथ लेके चले, एक बेहतर भारत का निर्माण करें, और जहाँ पर एक बेहतर उस मंजिल तक हम पहुंच पाएँ जो अभी भी अधूरे रह गए. जितना मेरा योगदान रहा 12 साल में मैं कर पाया, आप सबके लिए मेरी शुक्रगुजार हूं मैं, आपने ये मौका दिया. बेशक जितनी भी हमारे बीच में तनाव होती रही, लेकिन कभी कभी हंसी मजाक भी हो जाती थी, और आज भी जैसे जैसे वो होती रही, लेकिन मकसद को ना भूले. I only hope that... Thank you very much for giving me this option again. Thank you.
Yes. Thank you. Thank you, Yechury ji, for concluding it is a good note, pleasant note. Yechury ji, thank you for concluding it with a pleasant note, a humorous note. Now,